I'm never drinking or using drugs again.
Are you sure about that?
I'm 100% positive.
I did that myself, man, on the word processor. See, yeah. I did two different types of
That sounds of print. Good. The description sounds intriguing.
You know, Mike, I could really use your expertise at remembering things to figure out where frame 6962 is at this point.
Well, this is definitely a sign of voodoo.
Why is it a sign of voodoo?
It's an unnatural cross, Mark. It's not like a...
What, do you think when Jesus was hanging there, he thought it was natural?
Are you coming down here tomorrow, Mark?
Yes, but I gotta work at the cemetery tomorrow.
He asked me to come over and help him out. He said he needs some help. I'm always helping him with his films and we used to do a lot of partying together, but I don't party anymore. I was in The More the Scarier 3.
What was that about?
That was about, well, we were riding into a cemetery in the back of a truck, and we were drinking vodka, and I was playing my guitar, and then it's a silent film, and then we go out into the woods, and there's this mystery killer that's killing all of us.
Dude, what's up, man? I ain't seen you for a while. Your smiling face.
Yeah,
what the hell you got to say for yourself,
happy
man?
Happy Thanksgiving.
Happy Thanksgiving, yeah, man. What do you have to say for yourself?
Nothing really.
What do you got in that bag?
Soda.
Soda?
Yeah.
Well, you're lucky we got all ends cartoon taken care of.
Yeah.
You look happier than hell, Jack.
Yeah, so do you.
Well, I ought to be, man. What do you know that we don't?
Well, I won $50 on a lottery ticket today. But I don't want them guys to know, because otherwise they'll want to borrow money from me. And $2, so I'll either win 10 or a dollar if I win.
No, I didn't win anything.
Life is hard.
Yeah, life is hard.
A potato. I need a Mac. I won $2 on this one.
Oh, you did?
Yeah, see? $2. $2 plus a potato is $2. I've been losing about 10 bucks a day for the last week. Here's what I think of the lottery. I think it's like when you play the lottery, sometimes you win and sometimes you lose, but it's better than using drugs or alcohol, because when you use drugs or alcohol, especially drugs, you always lose. One day I was partying in my basement, and I always used to get like pissed off inside because I would want to party really heavy and no one else would, you know. And then all of a sudden Mark came over, and it's either I had a bottle of vodka or he had a bottle of vodka. But anyway, we were drinking vodka, and I was so happy that I found someone who would drink vodka with me, you know. So and then Mark would drink vodka with me all the time. I'd go over there all the time, and we'd buy a fifth of vodka and we'd share it, you know. And that really made me happy.
Are you thankful, Mike?
I don't know. Some things, I guess. I don't really know. It's like I'm thankful that I won 50 bucks, you know, the other day. Thankful that I won $810 today. Thankful for all the food that I've been eating, you know, around Thanksgiving.
He came over and he put a smile on my face. I didn't even want to wake up tomorrow morning, man. I had nothing to look forward to. I'm thankful that Mike came over and he put a smile on my face, talking his shit.
And it's like the whole room is just filled with this thick green and red web, you know, and it's coming out of Laura, and it's coming out of the table, and it's coming out of the walls, and it's coming out of the floor, you know. And all of a sudden my face hit the table, you know, and I blacked out. So Laura dragged me outside and laid me on the grass, you know, hoping I'd wake up, you know. And then her grandma came home, who she lived with, you know, and her grandma called an ambulance, you know. So I'm laying in the hospital, passed out. They got my brain on a brain scanner, and you know how your brain's supposed to go beep beep beep
feet. Mine just went straight across, you know. And the doctor goes to my mom, he goes, I don't think your son is going to make it. Sorry, you know, I think he's going to die. You know, I don't think there's any way we can bring him, you know, wake him up or nothing, you know. So all of a sudden I smell this real strong smell, and it's smelling salts they got in front of my nose, and I start to wake up, and all I see is bright lights, and I'm like, damn, where the hell am I, you know? And then I realize I'm in the hospital, so I start checking my pockets for the acid, which they analyzed one hit. It turned out to be a blotter paper dipped in liquid PCP with a little bit of downer in it. And they said if it hadn't have been for that little bit of downer, I would be dead. But anyways, I'm checking my pockets for the acid, you know, because I was going to drop my other three hits in the hospital, you know. And all of a sudden, my mom walks in the room, and she's holding a bag of acid like this, you know. I'm like, damn, you know, now I can't drop it, the rest of my acid in the hospital. So she flushes it down the toilet, you know. And then they kept me in the hospital another month, and they said I was the worst case they ever had, and they let me go, and I continued using drugs all the way up until a little under a year and a half ago. And that's I have more stories like that I could tell you too. All kinds of drug related stories. Could tell you, you know, so I'll try and keep you awake with him tonight.
When I say take one, give it a couple seconds. Take one. That was wicked, man.
I'm hitting it as hard as I can, but it's not doing
okay.
Nothing.
Okay, there's one other thing. Mike, come down here real quick. I gotta get the headlights. Knock out, Do you think this is a little bit cathartic for you?
Very cathartic, Mark.
Do you know what cathartic means?
No.
It means, I think it means getting things out of your system, man.
Yeah, okay, then it's cathartic.
Is it? You got that out of your system?
Pretty damn cathartic, Mark.
Cool.
Hey man, you ripped that one song off, I hate to tell you, from Black Sabbath.
I didn't. Yes, I wrote did. All the words.
Yeah, but dude, I'm saying there's an unconscious influence.
Yeah, but all your ideas come from somewhere else, Mark. You can't make up an idea by yourself.
Well, no, dude.
It's got to come from somewhere, Mark.
Yeah, but that's
an idea for anything.
Yeah, but
have you
listened to the two? That's an exact copy.
No, it's not, though.
You changed one word.
No, I changed all. I used one word. I used the word
the fuck
insane, and that's it. What's that?
The Ghost of Christmas Past.
Oh.
You have to whisper, okay?
All right.
Okay, yeah, because otherwise we'll get into trouble.
What?
Dude, otherwise we'll get into trouble.
All right.
What do you think of the rewards of this, Mike?
I don't know, maybe you'd be a famous movie producer or something.
A what?
A famous movie producer.
What are the rewards of that?
I don't know. Sex, money, power.
Sex, money, power.
I don't know.
Would you buy this movie for $14.95?
Yeah, hell yeah, man, you know.
I could find 3,000 people like you across this country, man, I'm in business.
Of course, man, I mean, that's what rush tickets were.